What's up everyone, Nate Vincent here with another Tech Tips. This one's gonna be a little different. We're gonna be talking about the vacuum system in your car. In the past, European cars have not had vacuum pumps. They used vacuum from the intake manifold to run any sort of vacuum-operated devices inside the car. But now, recently, almost all European cars have vacuum pumps, whether it be a mechanical version like this driven by the engine, or an electric version like this driven by electricity from the car. We're gonna talk a little about these and why they're used on modern European cars, and then we're gonna dig in. We're actually gonna take this mechanical unit apart and show you how it works and how it creates vacuum. Let's jump in. Before we get into talking about the differences between the mechanical and the electric vacuum pump, let's talk about why vacuum is required in your engine bay to begin with. So your car needs vacuum to run a series of actuators. The first actuator is your brake servo. So if you didn't have a vacuum operated brake servo, when you go to push the brakes, it would require significantly more force to actually get the car to stop. So by having a little bit of vacuum there in the big vacuum solenoid that is called the brake servo, that helps assist the brakes and makes it easier on the driver. Now with the advent of turbocharging and direct injection, these cars require vacuum pumps. That's because the turbo actually creates boost, therefore there is no vacuum in the intake manifold where the old cars used to scavenge it from. Now the next thing is, like I said, we talked about turbocharged cars have these vacuum pumps. Well, turbocharged cars have wastegates and they have wastegate actuators. Almost all the time, these wastegate actuators are being operated by the vacuum produced by these pumps. Now looking at this, we have two styles of vacuum pumps. We have a mechanical style vacuum pump and we have electric style vacuum pump. Now let's start with the mechanical one. This is driven off something on the engine. They're driven off camshafts often, sometimes off lay shafts or other aspects of the engine. You'll also see that this uses engine oil to be lubricated. So you can see this actually goes into the engine, basically pulls the engine oil from the engine itself to lubricate itself and make sure it runs properly. Now, talk about a little bit the mechanical versus the electric. This is the mechanical pump, and you can see that this is driven by the camshaft on the engine. Now, not all mechanical pumps are driven by the camshaft. Some are driven by other elements of the engine, but they're almost all bolted to the engine, and they're almost all using engine oil as lubrication. Some of the plus sides to the mechanical driven vacuum pumps is they're very quiet in operation. Some of the downsides is they're harder to access. So this one is found behind the engine up against the firewall. It's a little bit trickier to get to. And the other thing is when the seals start to go bad and these start to not work as well, they actually take that engine oil from the engine and put it into the vacuum system itself. And that can cause some damage in the vacuum system. Now, the last thing we'll warn you about with these mechanical vacuum pumps is their affinity to seize up. So if a car has been sitting for a long time, not running, these pumps can seize up. And what happens if these pumps seize up or are serviced improperly, it can cause catastrophic engine damage if the engine has gone to be started without checking the vacuum pump first. What will happen is, in this case, this one is actually hooked to the camshaft. When the engine goes to rotate, the camshaft will not be able to rotate because of the vacuum pump being seized up, and that will cause the camshaft to break, some timing components to break, or the timing chain to break. We've seen it happen a number of times, and this is definitely something you want to be aware of. Now moving on to the electric vacuum pump, this is a more modern style vacuum pump. We're seeing this more often in European cars as it's a simpler design. One of the downsides to the current electric vacuum pumps is they tend to be a little bit noisier than their mechanical counterpart, but the benefit to this is it's so simple. So basically we have an electric motor in the bottom, we have a vacuum pump at the top, two bolts to hold it down, and a plug to plug it in. It's really that simple. It can be mounted anywhere in the engine bay, which I believe the engineers really prefer because they can move weight and you know, complexity around wherever they need it. It doesn't have to be bolted to the engine. And it also makes servicing it much easier as this thing is very easily accessed. So now that we understand the basics of these vacuum pumps and the vacuum system in your car, let's open up this mechanical vacuum pump and show you exactly how this actually operates and how it actually makes vacuum itself. So we know that this sits like this and this is driven by the camshaft. So as the camshaft spins this around, you can see I'm actually getting resistance here. This is going around constantly and is creating vacuum. So I can actually feel it creating vacuum right now. It's actually pulling my finger in as I spin this. You can't really see it, but it is. And I will say also on these mechanical pumps, the excess vacuum, so the air that's being pulled in, is pushed through this little check valve here, this little flapper valve into the engine. So that actually helps create a positive crankcase pressure at the same time. So now let's open up the back of it and show you exactly how this thing works. All right, so you can see that this spins this way, right here, to create vacuum. So now let's pop the cover off and take a look at this. So opening this up, you can see that I can pop the cover off the back You can see right there, we have a flat plane there, and we have this little rotor that's spinning around. Now, one thing you're gonna notice is that there's ports on different spots here. One right here, there's a hole there, and then one right here, there's a hole here. But what you're also going to notice is as this spins around, the size of the chambers changes. So if I show you, as that moves around, if you see that slider slides back and forth, changing the size of the port. So if you imagine right here, where this main port that goes to the brake booster is, you can see that this is a large expanse of volume in here. Now, it creates a seal, this rotor creates a seal, so as this comes around, now this fixed amount of air, you can see is significantly moved over to the other side, and then it's shrunk and pushed out through this little passageway you can kind of see right there. Now this passageway actually moves it right here by this little flapper valve, right there. And that flapper valve creates positive engine crankcase pressure. So as this moves around, it's constantly this changing volume as this thing spins, it's constantly taking air and it's pushing it into a different location. So it's basically constantly creating vacuum as it spins around. But you can also see that if this lacked lubrication, some moisture got in here, something of that nature, you can see how this could easily seize up or go crooked and jam up, and that would cause catastrophic engine damage, as this would not be able to spin, and being driven off the camshaft, that could cause some serious damage to the engine. So now looking at the electric one, you're gonna see pretty much the same sort of mechanism. This motor is gonna spin significantly faster than the camshaft in your engine spins, but what you're gonna see is an offset rotor, basically. So you're gonna see something like this, where it spins around, and as it spins around, that chamber increases and decreases in size or volume. And that change in volume is what's going to create vacuum. So some of the signs to know if your vacuum pumps are failing would be, like I said, oil in your vacuum lines on a mechanically driven vacuum pump, oil seeping around the vacuum pump itself. So, you know, if you take your boost actuator off or your brake booster hose off and you find that there's oil residue or a significant amount of oil in those hoses, that means that this is probably feeding oil from the engine into the system and not separating it properly, and that's gonna be an issue. Now with the electric ones, a little less to worry about. Obviously it's not as mechanical, doesn't relate to the engine as much, but what you'll notice, these will start to get really hot, they will start to not work as well, they'll start to make noise, things of that nature. Pretty easy to tell if something's wrong with it, but this is obviously a much easier and simple solution to fix as well, because this is just a few bolts, where this is usually somewhere attached to the engine. Well, I really hope you found this video helpful. I hope it helped you understand vacuum pumps in general, the vacuum system in your car. This is relatively new to modern European cars, so we kind of wanted to give you a little bit of color and what it does and why it's there, and also a little bit deeper understanding into how vacuum pumps actually work, so you can understand yourself what exactly is going on. Some tips and tricks, we suggest replacing the entire vacuum pump as a unit if it ever needs to be replaced, just to keep any sort of failures from happening or any sort of catastrophic engine failures from happening. So with that said, I hope you found this video helpful. If you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions at all, please leave them in the comments below, and we'll catch you on the next one.